Okay, everybody, we're on restart here. It's Janelle and Rachel from Posh Bridal, and today we're getting rid of the summer-spring beverages, and we're hailing in our fall-winter beverages here at Posh. So we thought we'd take you on that journey on how we do it here, because we like doing fun things for our brides. So we serve sangria during the week and weekends for our brides that would like. So that's our summer drink, so we thought we'd start with that. So first you're going to start with some either, we serve white wine, or you could use red wine at home, but we're going to use white wine here. And then you need a citrus and a regular fruit, so we're going to have an orange and an apple, and it's the flying apple, so we're going to have Rachel cut up that apple. And what we're going to do is just slice it up and make it into small pieces. We like to make it into small pieces because then it goes into the glasses pretty. And then if the bride or her guests want to be able to chomp on it a little bit, it's tasty then. And I like to peel off the skin of the oranges so that if they're going to eat it, it makes it nice and they can eat it. So we've got all of our fruit, and it's two fruits, so always get a citrus. So you could use pineapple too if you wanted to. And put this here so we can put that in. And we put our oranges and we put our apples in. And you use a full bottle, and of course we use box wine. And go, why is that? Because
we're classy.
Yes, right. Well, it's easy to store. And the other thing is you're adding other fruit flavors to it, so you don't need a fancy-dancy wine to get in there. So if you want to use a box wine because you're going to spruce it up a little bit, that's just fine. So box wine goes in there, the amount of what a full bottle would be, and then you need to use some brandy, which we use apple brandy because then the flavor goes in together, and you do about a half a cup to one bottle of wine. So we're going to pour that in. And that's it for the end of the season. Ta-da! No more brandy. We're done, all out. Dead bottle. One dead soldier. Okay? And then what you do is you take that and you stir it up really nice and you stick it in the refrigerator for about 10 hours. Make sure you cover it, so put it in like a Tupperware container to cover it. So now it's going to go to the fridge, and magically, at our Posh fridge, it comes back and it looks like this. Ta-da! And what we're going to do is shake her up. And we're going to bring over some lovely wine glasses. Okay? And we're going to put some ice in there. So we want to put some ice in. Thank you.
Richard has asked, what type of wine?
Well, we are using white wine. And we like to use Franzia Crisp White because it's a little bit drier and not so sweet, because we're adding this other sweetness but no sugar. And then we put some ice in there, and we're going to go ahead and pour some of that in. And we like to make ours a little bit on the sparkling side. And so after we pour it in, then we're going to top it off with a little seltzer water. And if you want, you can dig out some of the fruit and put some of the fruit in there so it makes it look really pretty.
That's a little time consuming.
Yeah, we're just going to take a little bit more than we want to today. And there we are. We've got lovely sangria. Cheers. That's pretty good.
Yeah, I've been serving this to all the brides that come in, and I've been dying to try some. So it's
really good. It's nice and light and refreshing. So, cheers. Yep, okay, that's it. We're done.
Great.
Okay, on to fall now. So we're going to clear out all of our stuff here. Let's get rid of that. Got to get rid of ice. We're going to get rid of our apple and our oranges.
Ta-da.
No, we're not throwing that on the floor. There is a trash can underneath, honey. Don't worry about it. Okay, so here, we're going to give you all this. Thank you very much. Okay, so this next recipe that we're going to talk about is apple cider, hot apple cider spiked. Because, you know, we have to have a little bit of fun with this. So, yes, we have, when I went shopping for rum, of course, they all have pirates on, so I had to get the one with the female pirate on, because we are Wonder Women, and here is our Wonder Woman pirate, so we had to get that. So you have get some rum. And what we have to get is, you want to get, here it is, apple cider. And you want to use real apple cider or unfiltered apple juice, because you don't want to use sparkling cider or hard cider or clear apple juice, because the flavoring won't be right. So make sure that you get the real thing. So, and once again, you don't have to get the best stuff at the market. You can get the store brand if you like. And we're going to put in a gallon. And you can do this. What's really cool about this is, if you're having a Halloween party or if you're having guests, and we're going to pour that whole thing in at home, and you're making arrangements with other ideas for the party, and we're going to be talking about that next week, you can do this 4 hours ahead in a crock pot. So pretend this is a crock pot, and we're pouring all this stuff in. So you put a gallon of your apple juice in. And then the next thing that you're going to put in is, we're going to put slice up some oranges. So if we can slice up some oranges there. And in this, you don't have to take the rind off if you don't want to. So it's not a big deal to take off that rind. And then after you do that, then what we're going to do is, we're going to take some fresh ginger, some cinnamon sticks, and some cloves. And we're going to take our ginger, and I'm sure you all know what ginger looks like. Ginger looks like this in the grocery store. So it looks like its roots. And you're going to peel off the bark on the outside, and you're going to about to use about 1.5 inches of this. And we're going to mince it up real nice. And there's 3 different things that you can do then. So we're going to put this orange in here. Okay, orange in. Okay. And then we have our minced
ginger,
thank you. And we have our cloves, whole cloves, not ground cloves, but whole cloves. And we have our cinnamon sticks, okay? So we're going to take 3 cinnamon sticks, 1, 2, 3, stick them in. Here we go. And of course, this is on low on a crock pot, but you can do it for 4 hours. But if you're going to put it on the stove in a large pot like this, it's only 1 hour on low. So, then you have a choice of doing your spices 3 different ways. Now we're going to make a bouquet garni. Do you know what that is?
I don't.
You don't? Well, see, Richard and I, on our honeymoon, went to Paris. And do you know what we did for the week when we were in Paris?
What did you do, Janelle?
We went to the Cordon Bleu cooking school.
Wow.
I know. Isn't that cool on a honeymoon? So, anyhow, one of the things that we learned about was a bouquet garni. And a bouquet garni is usually used in making sauces. But you can use that same deal with making something that we're going to do today, because you don't want these things loose in the bowl floating around. So there's 3 ways we can skin a cat. We can get a tea bag holder that looks like this, and this is so cute. I happened to pick this up at the store today, and I thought the black cat for Halloween was appropriate, and it's got a little fish. So you can, isn't that cute?
I love it.
Yeah. So you can stuff this in with, you need approximately about 5 cloves or so, you know, do a little handful like that. Put your cloves in, put your ginger in, and then you close this up, and you're going to put this in there. Or if you want to get fancy and make your own thing, you can use a coffee filter if you like. Or would you like to hand me the cheesecloth and the cord and the scissors, please? What's nice is, you can go to the grocery store if you want to, and you can use cheesecloth if you like. And so the 2 other ways that we can do this is, you need to do double layer childproof wrapping, of course.
And adult-proof.
And adult-proof, that's right. So get yourself a piece of cheesecloth here. And so you take your piece of cheesecloth, and we're going to take some of this ginger and put your ginger. I'm going to use my fingers faster. All chefs do it that way anyway. So put your ginger in there. Okay, what do I do? Put your cloves. Yep. And then, nope, actually, we're going to leave that attached. And you're going to take, wrap this just like this. Go ahead, let's wrap it around, knot it, Tight. Tight. Okay. Good. And then after we do that, if you leave this on, then you can dangle it in and put it in. Then you have a fish way to fish it out rather than just cutting it off and just letting it kind of stir around. So you can do it that way or this way, or you can do that same thing with this. Make a little thing like this and it goes right in there. Easy peasy, okay? So now that's going to boil up for about an hour on the kitchen stove. And then after that is all done, we're gonna put these things away. So I'm gonna give them back to my assistant here. Let's clear off our table. And this is really super easy. And we're gonna get our lovely, yep, thank you. And we're gonna get our lovely coffee cups. Oops, no, I need the cinnamon. Thank you very much. And can we have our coffee cups, please? So now we have our coffee cups, and this is boiled. And through the magic of television now, this is all done. And we're going to now ladle this into our cups. It's gonna be so pretty and it's gonna smell so good. And you know, it is nutritious because it's apples and all these fun things and everything. And then we're actually going to take one of our oranges and we're gonna slice up one of our oranges. Yes, we should have the cutting board back over here. And let's put a little orange into our glass. Thank you. Thank you. And of course you want to put a cinnamon stick in here because it makes it pretty. Now for the spiking. So you can serve this up like this, and that'll work for any adult or child. But if you want to, for a small cup like this, you can take and you do half an ounce, a half a little jigger of the rum, and put it into each one of your cups as your guests are coming. And that way you have it spiked or you have it unspiked. And there you go. I'm going to take the spike one because I've had a long day. So there we go. So cheers, everybody. Welcome to fall. Look forward to seeing you at Posh Bridal to enjoy some of our hot apple cider with or without rum. And we'll see you then and see you next week. Thanks for coming. See you later.